We are now in Saad Allah al-Jabiri Square, one of the main squares in the Aleppo city in northern Syria. This square was known as the Death Square when the rebels were in control of the eastern part of Aleppo. This square also witnessed the first explosions that targeted Aleppo city. Three car bombs rocked this square in October of 2012, killing over 30 people and injuring many others. The aim of the explosion was to infiltrate the government-controlled areas in western Aleppo. Of course, now, 7 months after the army wrested control over the eastern part of Aleppo city, this square has become safe and has become an attraction for people who either come to pass by or to come during the evening and have some rest here. Of course, during the course of the Syrian crisis, this square has witnessed also several mortar attacks, daily mortar attacks, and rockets also. Over there is a destroyed building. This was a hotel that was targeted in the first explosion when three suicide car bombers detonated their cars here in the square, and the blast then in 2012 was followed by an attempt by the rebels to infiltrate this with bomb vests. Of course, the attack was foiled, and this square remained under the government control throughout the crisis, but no one could come near because it was a daily target of mortar shells and improvised rockets. Now, as we can see people moving freely, walking, and the normal life has returned to this square. Over there, we can see maintenance workers also starting to fix the damaged parts of the square. And people are now going and coming through this square today, their daily jobs or schools or their daily life. Okay, so let's try to talk with one of the people here in the square. Let's meet.
عارفين حضرتك؟
اسمك ايالي.
لما احكينا شوي، انت كبنت من حلب، هي الساحه شو بتعني للحلبيين وشو صار خلال الازمه حتى انحرمتوا؟
هلا هي ساحه سعد الله الجابري انتم موجودين فيها، وهي اكبر ساحه بحلب تعتبر. نحن هون كنا نقيم فعاليات نشاطات، يعني اهل حلب حتى نحن الطبقه المتوسطه بيجوا بيسهروا هون. طبعا بالحرب لا، ما كان فينا نعمل هاي القصص، لانه هاي ساحه تحول اسمها لساحه الموت، يعني نحن مسمينها ساحه الموت لانه كان في قناصين، يعني كان في عندنا قناص من هذيك الجهه، في قناص من هون، فهي الساحه بالمنتصف ما كان حدا يقدر يمشي، ولكن كنا بنقدر نروح عن طريق الحديقه العامه.
Okay, so she said that this Saad Allah al-Jabri Square is one of the largest squares in Aleppo, of course, but during the crisis and because of the mortar attacks and explosions, the name has become the Death Square because no one dared to come here. Before the crisis, people would come here and hold events, and maybe some celebrations, and of course it was an attraction site for the mid-class people who cannot afford to go to high-end restaurants or hotels, so they would come here in the evening and enjoy the breeze and enjoy the events being held here. But throughout the crisis this has stopped. But now, 7 months later, after the army took control over the entire Aleppo city, life has returned to this square. Let's try to talk with some other people.
يعطيك العافية. مرحبا. بس تحكي لنا شوي عن ساحة سعد الله الجابري، بالنسبة للحلبيين كيف رجعتوا هلا عم تروحوا تجوا؟
والله أنا بالنسبة لي أنا مسافر من غير بلد، يعني ماني من هون.
Okay, so this guy said that he is from outside Aleppo, but of course this is something good because now people from outside Aleppo, from other provinces, are coming to the city either for job or for work. This is another family maybe we will meet. يعطيك العافية.
الله يعافيك.
حضرتك حلبي من هون؟
ايه.
ساحة سعد الله الجابري شو بتعني لكم؟
هي رمزنا وهي صمودنا وهي كل شيء كل شيء رمز لنا.
هي الساحة بالذات خلال فترة وجود المسلحين ما كانت تقدر تمشوا فيها. هلا لما رجعتوا تجوا لهون شو حسيتوا؟
نحس بأمان، نحب استقرار، نحب وطننا، نحب نضل ساحة سعد الله، ما نحب نغيره يعني.
انبسطتي لما رجعتي تمشي؟
ليه ابوس ترابه.
عم تجي المسا تادي ولا؟
والله من برمضان جيت مرتين ثلاثة.
ايه.
So she says that this square is a symbol of Aleppo and that she was so happy that the square returned and that she also comes here during the evening to sit and enjoy her time here. Yes. Okay, so here we have another person from Aleppo. He's here also to talk to us about the square and also about the return of Aleppo as a safe city again. يعطيك العافية.
الله يعافيك. أهلا وسهلا.
احكي لنا شو رمزية سعد الله الجابري بالنسبة لكم كحلبيين؟
ساحة سعد الله الجابري بتعني شيء كتير كبير كتير للحلبية. هي ساحة الأفراح. دائما الحلبية لما بيكون عندهم أفراح بتجتمع بساحة سعد الله الجابري لحتى تعبر عن فرحتها وتعبر عن سرورها وتعبر عن هناها. فساحة سعد الله الجابري تاريخ حلب.
طيب خلال الحرب ما عاد تقدر الناس تجي لهون، شو حسيت بوقتها؟
أكبر جرح لحلب هو عدم اجتماع المواطنين في ساحة سعد الله الجابري.
وهلا شو حاسس؟
هلا أكيد أكيد الانفراج، انفراج على حلب وعلى أهل حلب. وهالناس عم بتروح وبتجي وبالليل كمان بتسهر، تجي بتسهر الناس في ساحة سعد الله، شيء عظيم جدا جدا.
يعطيك العافية.
أهلا وسهلا.
الصين. Okay, so this man said that this square is so important for the people of Aleppo. It's the square of joy and the square of happiness. Whenever there is some happy event, it will be held in this square. Throughout the crisis, when the rebels were in the eastern part of Aleppo, he said that maybe all of the Aleppo people were wounded also because of the war here and because they were deprived of coming to this place. And now that they're being able to come back, it's a great joy for them. Okay, so the square now is safe and people are living their normal lives. They have gotten rid of the mortar shells, the rockets landing here, and from two snipers, one in that direction in Bab al-Nasr and the other in Bustan al-Qasr. Two snipers, one of them was stationed here in the depth of this lane and the other one was there. So now no snipers and no mortar shells and life is returning to Aleppo.